I'm going to show you how to create app icons like you would see in an iOS like these for any type of app that you would want inside of Midjourney. I'm going to show you how to craft the prompt. We're just going to go over that. So I'm running off of some ideas from Toots prompts, and here's kind of how these prompts are set up. So I'm just going to take this one and we're going to start here, and I'm just going to kind of show you what that would yield us. I'm going to do the imagine prompt. Pass that in. What we're going to do is we're going to go over to ChatGPT, and I'm going to build a whole prompt out. What I'm going to ask ChatGPT to help us do is craft some ideas of some applications and then decide what the design concept would be for the logo, and then provide us prompts that we can then use to create stuff like this. So I'm going to formulate that real quick. So my prompt is going to look like this. I'm going to say, I want you to take this Midjourney prompt for an iOS app application or app icon. And here's that. I say, I want you to make it more detailed and much better. And then I want you to create 10 concept ideas for applications, and then give me a prompt that provides a design idea for its app icon. So we're going to let that load, and then we're going to pass those in, and we're going to find out what's wrong with them, and then we're going to refine from there. So we get the output. We decide how to describe what's wrong with the prompt, tell ChatGPT, and then ChatGPT will take that feedback and then hopefully give us something better. So it really fixated on the onigiri, and that's not the point. So I'm going to say, I don't care about the onigiri. That's just a random idea. Give me ideas of other types of apps. And this might take a second. We might actually have to refresh this. I'm going to do that real quick. And there we go. We're right back. So it's going to give us some app concepts. And then we're going to see right here. So this is for Eco Tracker and FitMinder. Let's see what's up with that. Let's see stylized heart rate line. That's pretty cool. Travel Mate. That's an interesting idea. Okay. I'm going to see how these come out. Budget Buddy, okay, sounds like Mint Mobile. Interesting. Okay, so we definitely have an icon or logo type thing evolving here. I think this one is maybe the most like app-like. That's pretty good. We'll go ahead and I'm going to take that one. This one, I think that's probably the best one out of this. And then these, I don't think any of these are really good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell ChatGPT, I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to say none of these prompts provide a style that looks enough like an iOS app icon. And so we'll see what it does with that feedback. And it's automatically just going to give us some revisions. And so let's go ahead and see what the deal is with that. With that added info. I'm only going to throw a couple of these in real quick. Ones that we've already had. And then as you can see up here, it did get confused because it gave us a mock-up of a personal finance app, which is great. But not what we're looking for. Same with this one. That was probably my bad. I probably copied and pasted the description instead of the actual icon request. So let's see what this gives us. These are already starting to look a lot more like iOS apps. Okay, not bad, but not really iOS-y. All right, cool. These are the new Leaf ones. I think this one's really good, and as is that one. So I'm actually going to take that. And then I'm going to take... look up here. Let's see. Where's the other one? Oh, here we go. There's this one. And then, yeah, we have some other ones here, too. I like the inset. That's pretty cool. So I'm going to rock with that one. And... cool. Let's throw some more of these in here, because where it says rounded square iOS app icon, that is the key thing that is helping us. So let's see if we can get that. Do this. And what else? Home organizer. Yeah, that's pretty cool. And I'll see all these when they're done. Okay, so we had some of the prompts come in. I've got this one. This is the pet one. Pretty cool. I kind of like this right here. I think this is probably this one or this one are the best designs. So we'll see what those look like. And the house one. It's pretty good, but there's not a check mark. And that's something we wanted. But if I'm just judging off of what we got, I'll take... this one up here, but I will respin the whole thing. For the language app, we got this. And here's the house with the check mark on the app. This one's kind of weird. This is probably the only other option, and it's kind of a faint white, so we'll just act like that never happened, or we'll respin it again. You know what? Why not? This is the one that I got out of the first batch that was pretty good, so I'm not really mad about that. Let's see what else. Well, hey, I think at this point you kind of get the idea, right? So if you have a design for an app and it's not turning out exactly the way that you want for your icon, just describe it a little bit more. Pass things back and forth with ChatGPT. Describe what's not happening visually, because basically GPT can't see that. You just have to go back and forth. And then ultimately, you're probably going to come out with a prompt that's going to get what you want. So overall, I hope this was helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.